In Encinitas, hours ago, a happy reunion between a domestic violence survivor and her two dogs. That reunion possible because of a new law.
New at 6, our tenders reporter Michael Chin reveals how protecting pets will also help protect human victims.
Hi, guys. Hi.
This is the moment Amber has been waiting a month for. A chance to reunite with her dogs. The joy here in stark contrast to the last few years of her 6-year marriage.
He's slapped me in the face. He's punched me in the head.
Amber says her husband became physically abusive toward her and the dog starting about 2.5 years ago. One of the reasons she didn't leave him, the safety of her dogs.
I didn't trust him alone with the dogs. I didn't feel comfortable leaving them in his care.
Eventually, an incident of abuse involving one of her dogs forced Amber's hand. She found the Animal Safe House program at Rancho Coastal Humane Society, which helps pet owners in crisis, most of them domestic violence survivors. While her dogs stayed at the facility, Amber got a protective order against her husband, then entered a month-long treatment for PTSD related to domestic violence. Animal Safe House coordinator Justina Kirkland says many abusers attack pets to maintain control over the victim.
Typically in those situations, the survivor's main support system, they're very close to them and they provide unconditional love.
That reality, a focus of a new bipartisan federal law, which expands protections for pets while adding funding for domestic violence shelters to provide for pets or find accommodations for them.
According to studies, about a third of domestic violence survivors report staying in abusive relationships because of the welfare of their pets. Upwards of a quarter actually return to abusive relationships for the same reason.
Something Amber says she won't be doing because she knows her dogs are safe. Michael Chen, 10 News.
Right now, only 3% of domestic violence shelters allow pets. That new law also makes it a crime to travel across state lines to violate a restraining order and harm a pet.